part of a very large family. And all my sisters did their masters and they were gold medalists. And my daughter, she was working with McKinsey in Singapore and then she got married into a business family. There's been the traditional expectation in our society. Definitely today that thing has changed. If you ask me, not even good at making a cup of tea, but if you were to ask my son, he's a good cook. So I think the roles change. I think along with the changing times, the way we look at things change. You really see there are lots of examples of women who have been extremely successful. We had a female prime minister in our country even before Britishers. So I don't know why all this talk about that in our country there is a reluctance of accepting women in authority. To some extent, we have to just get it out of our mind, you know. There's no distinction. So if you're going to keep on having that sense of limitation, then you are beginning with a handicap in your mind. And I would urge all my women colleagues to just discard that. Maybe today they feel that they are in a minority. Just forget about it, you know. I mean, why do you want to, you know, allow it to play in your mind? So my advice to them would be also that be the change you want to be, you know. Because the more you showcase the success, the more you will be able to motivate people for even greater success. And let your professional accomplishments and results show that. You know, the future is going to be all of women. With the way the ladies are performing in terms of their education or in terms of the careers that they want to build, it's going to happen. Pani ke pravah ko koi nahi rok sakta, wo apna rasta bana lega. It's maybe time for men to start thinking that what will they need to do to remain in the race.